Welcome to the seventh development log for Chronicle Destiny. This occasion, I was able to implement gamepad controls of what I currently have so far, which is just basically movement, basic attack, and the dialogue controls. So this is the current build so far. And that supports gamepad. It still supports the keyboard. Everything still works. WASD is for movement. The J key is for attack. And the shift key is for the dialogue. Right now I just changed the look of the dialogue to better reflect the gamepad support. When I release it, it talks. Right now, if an NPC is in a conversation, it starts following. Once it drops out of the conversation, it stops. There we go. K and I is to navigate the dialogue options. And U is to silence. Zero is to hide the debug view, and one is to reset. So now with gamepad support, if I have a gamepad connected, which on the third line on debug, it says GP connections, 12, meaning there's 12 slots available on this device. Depending on the device, it could mean in this location 12 slots, and another device it could mean there's 12 actual devices connected, or 6 or 3. But there's only one device connected, and that is the first index. And if I press start, gamepad, it switches the first line to gamepad, and now I'm controlling it with the gamepad. The A button is for attacking, and that still works. For dialogue, is the right bumper. In this occasion, it starts out silent rather than with keyboard that starts with the first index selected. In order to actually select something, I use the right thumbstick. Select something and let go of the right bumper, and it basically talks. And depending how far I tilt the right thumbstick, it will activate or stay silent. And same thing, I can talk to an NPC. And once it drops out of conversation, it stops following me. This also works on the website. The keys still work, just like I said previously. J for tag, shift for dialogue, navigate, silence, zero for debug view, one to reset. And if I press the start on a gamepad, the gamepad is now providing the input data, and that's what I'm using. And also additionally, this is a Android device, right? As it is an Android device, and right now it says that the input is keyboard, but there's no keyboard attached to it. But if I press start on a Bluetooth gamepad, it switches to the gamepad and I can control it as expected. Everything still works. And everything works as expected. So yeah, that was last week's goals. It was the gamepad input, touchscreen input, and dialogue progression. However, I was only able to accomplish gamepad input. So So next week's input, I'm gonna focus on dialogue progression, and after I finish with that, I will be implementing the touch screen input. So on the news, nothing much has changed, right? Again, you can go to my website, bluestar03.com. You can find the latest build there to test out. And I'm still going to GDC Expo March 18th to the 20th at San Francisco. But yeah, it has impacted this year's GDC. There's a couple exhibitors that have opted not to go. Some big ones are Epic, what's it called, Amazon, and one that I wanted to look forward to was Microsoft, what they had to show off during GDC. So it is going to be very different, I think, especially those usually have really big floor presence on the expo. But yeah, anyways, that's all I've done this week. Thanks for watching.